Welkom, Revelation 18. After this, I saw another angel coming down from heaven, having great authority, and the earth was made bright with his splendor. Another angel than the earlier seven angels which we encountered earlier. He is lightning with his splendor the whole earth. And he called out with a mighty voice, "Fallen, fallen is Babylon the Great. It has become a dwelling place of demons, a haunt of every fool spirit, a haunt of every fool and hateful birds, for all nations have drunk the wine of her impure passion, and the kings of the earth have committed fornication with her. And the merchants of the earth have grown rich with the wealth of her wantonness." Babylon is fallen. It doesn't exist anymore. Revelation 18 shows God's final judgment. Mankind is saying, "I don't need God. I'm wealthy, I'm intelligent. We have all kinds of science. We are mighty, we don't need God." And in a single blow, God finished their wealth and power. And the world watches astonished. They have lost their source of income and lost their merchandise. The great city Babylon is destroyed. The world built upon earthly matters. Their intelligence, their richness, their power, their buildings, their wealth, and how transitory are these earthly things. Only what one builds for God, that's imperishable. See 1 Corinthians 3, the verses 10 to 15. Only if you build with gold, precious stone and silver, that has value. And all the other things, hey, it will burn. There's no value. If you are not working in the kingdom of God, proclaiming the gospel, not supporting, if you attend your gifts to proclaim the gospel, that has no value. It is not imperishable. It will be burned, and you are not building upon the fundament of Jesus Christ. And Babylon becomes at once and for all eternity completely destroyed. And with Babylon and all which it stands for, Man with his sinful nature against God, wishing to know nothing about God, boosting human nature, yoga, to be able to save oneself in favor of Satan and the beast, the evil angels, worshipping Satan, church of Satan, demons, your own free human will. We don't need the laws of God. If we wish to abort, if we wish to terminate life, we are in power. The sex you wish to have, you do freely. If you wish to fornication, no problem. Humans are building on power and wealth and selfishness. That all is destroyed in one day, as we read later on, in 1 hour. But there is only one who has the power, namely God Almighty, the creator of men, of heaven and earth. So what means that Babylon has become a dwelling place of demons? Well, the angel, we read here another angel coming down from heaven with great authority. He made the earth bright with his splendor, illuminating the whole earth. And he calls out with a mighty voice, "Fallen, fallen is Babylon the Great." He said, "Continue to read. Come out of her, my people, lest you take part in her sins, lest you share in her plagues, for her sins are heaped high as heaven, and God has remembered their iniquities. Render to her as herself has rendered, and repay her double for her deeds. Mix a double draught for her in the cup she mixed." Here is the warning. Flee the Babylon. If you stay in Babylon, you will participate in the wrath of God. Because she, Babylon, glorified herself, the beast, and played the wanton. So give her a light measure of torment and mourning, since in her heart, the beast, she says, "A queen I sit, I am no widow, mourning I shall never see." She's proudly, she demands worshipping. She says, "I am a queen, I rule the world, I am no widow, I shall see never mourning, I am eternal. If you worship me, look how great my wealth is, and I shall give you wealth." I am powerful. Verse 9. And the kings of the earth who committed fornication and were wanton with her will weep and wail over her when they see the smoke of her burning. They will stand off in fear of her torment and say, Helios, Helios, the great city, the mighty city Babylon, in 1 hour has thy judgment come. Here it is stated that the merchandise, they are weeping, they are mourning, because in 1 hour Babylon is destroyed. And the merchants of the earth weep and mourn for her, since no one buys their cargo anymore. Cargo of gold, silver, jewels and pearls, fine linen, purple, silk and scarlet, all kinds of scented wood, all articles of ivory, all articles of costly wood, bronze, iron and marble, senegum, spice, incenses, myrrh, frankincense, wine, oil, fine flour and wheat, cattle and sheep, horses and chariots, and slaves, that is, human souls. Look how wicked this city is. Slaves, human souls, human slaves. You are able to buy in that great Babylon in the future, in the final time of the great tribulation. This city is great. The fruit of it, that is so long, has gone from thee, and all thy identities and thy splendor are lost to thee, never to be found again. The merchants of these wares who gained wealth from her will stand far off in fear of her torment, weeping and mourning aloud, Helios, Helios, for the grand city that was clothed in fine linen, in purple and scarlet, bedecked with gold, with jewels, and with pearls. In 1 hour all their wealth has been laid waste. And all shipmasters and seafaring men, sailors, and all those who trade is on the sea stood far off and cried out as they saw the smoke of her burning. They stood far off. Seamen, sailors. So it is clear this city is on the waters, as we read earlier, near a harbor. They are all standing far off because this city is smoke. It doesn't exist anymore. They are wandering. Verse 18. What city was like the great city Babylon? No city on earth was equally Babylon. As the splendor, as the wealth and wickedness. Souls, slavery, and these merchants, they threw dust on their head as they ripped and mourned, crying out, Alas, alas, woe, woe, for the great city where all who had ships at sea grew rich by her wealth. In 1 hour she has laid waste. Definite, eternal, demons, evil spirits will take possession of the ruins. This place will be found no more. The final of the beast, the satanic power. Verse 20. Rejoice over her, O heaven, O saints and apostles and prophets, for God has given judgment for you against her. Then a mighty angel took up a stone like a great millstone and threw it into the sea, saying, So shall Babylon, the great city, be thrown down with violence and shall be found no more. I don't know, Pasifel, a great millstone, kilometers in size, will be thrown in the sea and will cause a great tsunami. And that will definitely finish with Babylon. Nobody will survive that tsunami. All in the city will be killed. Verse 22, and the sound of harpers and minstrels, of flute players and trumpeters, shall be heard in thee no more. There were very many festivals in that city. And a craftsman of any craft shall be found in thee no more. And the sound of the millstone shall be heard in thee no more. No spices. And the light of lamp shall shine in thee no more. And the voice of the bridegroom and bride shall be heard in thee no more. No more festivals, no more weddings. For thy merchants were the great men of the earth, and all nations were deceived by thy sorcery. And in her was found the blood of prophets and saints. The beast murdered all the saints, all those who worshipped Jesus Christ and refuse the mark. It is the end of the great Babylon. It is finished with the power of the beast, the false prophet, finished with Satan. It is the end. There is only one ruler, and that is God Almighty. God permitted it, and Satan lost, the beast lost. People on earth, human beings followed, worshipped at great festivals, and in 1 hour it is all destroyed. That's the ultimate and final judgment of God upon wicked men. So think very well how you are living. Remember 1 Corinthians 3, the verses 10 to 15. If now, today, you are building upon the fundament of Jesus Christ or not, if you will receive a reward in heaven, but that will only be if you build with things like gold, silver and precious stone which can withstand fire. If not, it will be burned. Is wood, hay, stubble, each man's work will become manifested in front of the tribunal of Jesus Christ. If it can't withstand the fire, the wood, the hay, the stubble, it will be burned and you will receive no reward. Corinthians 3:15, if any man's work is burnt up, he or she will suffer loss, though he or she, him, herself, will be saved, but only as through fire. So, and that is valid for those who are taken up at the rapture of the church. They will be just in front of the tribunal of Jesus Christ. Don't be mistaken about that. Think seriously about your life today, how you will continue until the day of the rapture of the church. Heavenly Father, open our eyes. If you haven't accepted Jesus Christ as your Savior, please open your heart and tell Jesus Christ that you invite him to come into your heart and accept him as Savior, that you will accept the Holy Spirit as your guidance and to explain the Bible and teach you, so that you will be taken up at the rapture of the church and you will not pass through the great tribulation. Don't let me be stubborn, but submissive to you, because you, God, are the Creator. Help me, please. Amen.